Today I'm giving you 5 ways to quickly and dramatically increase your Adobe Premiere Pro playback and timeline performance and speed. These are easy things you can do for the most part, and we're diving right into our first one, which is make sure you close all unneeded and unwanted applications or programs that you're not using. Premiere Pro is definitely a hog when it comes to resources, as you might know, and closing everything, and I mean everything, your email, your browser, your calculator, these are gonna help to bring resources into that and have a much better and faster experience. So close everything you don't need and you will thank me later. Number 2 is make sure Premiere Pro is up to date. Now Adobe does give us some updates from time to time that do make a pretty drastic difference in the performance. And I know you like to stick to what you know and there are bugs from time to time, but if you haven't updated in a few months or even years, it's definitely well worth it to get some of the newer stuff that's available and improve performance across the board. Number 3 is make sure if you do have a capable GPU that hardware acceleration is turned on. Now go into your settings and make sure that this is applicable to you. It's not gonna be for everybody's system depending on what you've got, but it will make a pretty darn big difference from rendering times to everything in between when it comes to editing and everything to do with your playback performance as well. So if it is an option for you or if you can find a way to enable it, make sure you do that and you will see a big performance boost. Next up is utilize an SSD for your current project. What you're working on now, make sure is on your SSD, and that's going to allow your computer to access a lot faster than having it on an HD, an old hard drive that, you know, spins up and whatnot. And that does take time and it's going to result in the program not being as quick. If you're like me and you have a ton of content, you're gonna need to store that stuff on an HD, but you wanna have your current project on an SSD for a lot better and faster results. And number 5, this is the thing that made the biggest and the most dramatic difference, at least doubling the speed of Premiere Pro. It was mind-blowing to me and I'm so happy that I did it, although it did cost a tiny bit of money, and that was upgrade my RAM and specifically my RAM speed. I did have 3200 megahertz RAM from my old build that I kept into my new build here, but with the newer Ryzen stuff specifically, it does like really, really fast RAM. So I upgraded to 3600 megahertz RAM and I could not believe the difference in playback, in performance, in everything on my entire computer, in fact. But as far as Adobe Premiere Pro is concerned, RAM speed apparently makes a massive difference. So that's my number 1 tip. If you can swing it, if you can upgrade or sell your old RAM for a bit and get some better, newer stuff that's faster, 100% do that because it changed my life. I'm much happier. It's way faster, guys. And while we're talking about RAM, one last tip is that in your preferences down in memory, you can actually allocate how much of your RAM you want to go towards Premiere Pro opposed to other programs. So like I said, if you are just using Premiere Pro, ideally without a bunch of programs opened, you can dedicate as much RAM as you possibly can to this to allow for a faster and better workflow. There's 5 tips for you to hopefully help you dramatically increase and save you from pulling out your hair when it comes to Premiere Pro, guys. I hope you liked this video and it helped you out. If it did, consider hitting that like and subscribe button, join the community, and like always, make mistakes, be yourself, and get out there and take some more pictures. See you next time.